Welcome back. You're here with us on Urban Debate. I'm Hina Gambhir. Let's now talk about India's vaccination drive and the coverage so far. Karnataka ranks first among all the major states of India to administer the first dose of COVID vaccine to the eligible population, followed by Gujarat and then Madhya Pradesh. Till 9th of December, 94.57% of the 4.89 crore eligible population in the state has been inoculated with the first dose. According to COVID data, till a week ago, Karnataka, in fact, was at third position as far as the first dose is concerned. But now it is followed by Gujarat with 94.46% vaccination rate and Madhya Pradesh with 93.83% of the target population that has been already covered with the first dose of COVID vaccine. Then there are at least 10 states that have vaccinated less than 40% people. Now, big states like Maharashtra have only 36% that are fully vaccinated. Uttar Pradesh has only 25% that are fully vaccinated. So that's something that we are now going to be debating on Urban Debate this evening as to why is there, this kind of lag that we are seeing in other states. While some states, of course, are moving quite fast, the vaccination rate is picking up pace, and especially after the Omicron threat, it has become even better. But why is it that there are still some states which are lagging behind? That's going to be our discussion over the next 30 minutes. And our focus is also going to be on the fact that on one hand, of course, a company like Serum Institute of India is now indicating that it will be, reducing its COVID vaccine output because there is not enough demand coming. The center says we can't really put in, give more orders because the states, of course, have got enough stock of COVID vaccine lying with them. So why is it lying with them? Why is the vaccination drive not picking up pace, especially in a few states? For example, if you look at Gujarat right now, in Gujarat, 58% of the population is fully vaccinated. In Himachal Pradesh, 74% of the population is fully vaccinated right now. This is the latest data that we have at this point in time. Sikkim also has got over 70% population fully vaccinated right now. However, states like Bihar, the vaccination rate is much low, only 30%. In Delhi as well, the vaccination rate is just about 39%. And just look at the number that we are showing to you on your screen as well. How the first dose that has been administered in Delhi, it is only in about 59% of the population. Total population is about 2.44 crores. Only 59% have been given the first dose and fully vaccinated is only about 96 lakh, 39% of population. So why is it that some states are lagging behind? In fact, when our vaccination drive started in January this year. Joining us on the broadcast this evening is Dr. Sameer Kagalkar, spokesperson BJP Karnataka. We have with us Dr. Sanjeev Bagai, chairman Nephron Clinic. We're also joined by Dr. Manisha Kayande, spokesperson and MLC Shiv Sena. Good evening to all of you. Let me first begin with the representative of the BJP from Karnataka here, because Karnataka is seeing a spike in the vaccination rate as well. In the last few days specifically, the number has gone up. So what really changed? The Omicron threat?
Everyone. First and foremost, there's been a good amount of commitment, sincerity to the cause, the larger cause that we are in the midst of a once-in-a-century kind of a pandemic. And it is the duty, responsibility of the leaders, along with the society, to take measures that will ensure that there is a stopping of the infection and make sure that there is very little recurrence, right? So that being the case, there is always a constant endeavor to make sure that the goal, which we had set at the beginning of the vaccination program, that at the earliest possible time, probably even within the end of the calendar year 21, make sure that we get all the eligible adult population jabbed. So this being the case, and this being the goal in front of the government, notwithstanding the fact that the day-to-day running of the government on the economy front, on the other aspects of governance, had to be also given focus on. This was always on the top priority for states like Karnataka. I mean, you had a very strong leadership. Our former CM Yediyurappa ji ensured that he himself drove it. He had a complete control in terms of what the action needs to be taken. He had a set of able ministers, Dr. Sudhakar, Dr. Ashwath Narayan, and the technical advisory committee consisting of eminent doctors. So the focus was very much there. And as you see, the results are here to see for everyone. Karnataka is doing exceedingly good. And I'm sure it is going to continue to doing good, given the fact that the focus is only one thing, that's good governance, in this case of specific case of healthcare.
Okay. Dr. Manisha Kayande, I am in Mumbai as well, for last 2 weeks now. And if at all I have to go to a mall, I have to show my certificate of COVID vaccine. I need to be fully vaccinated. But then why still, if you see the population that is fully vaccinated, the target population is below 40%? Because, you know, if you are not allowing fully vaccinated people to even enter into malls and some restaurants and other such places, then why is the rate so low still?
Well, I would like to tell you, Hina, that Maharashtra is among the first five states, okay, which your figures show. As compared to Karnataka and other states, Karnataka has a population of about 6.4 crores and Maharashtra has a population of 12.7. So it's almost half the population. Karnataka is 52% vaccinated. Maharashtra is 36% vaccinated. As compared to the other states, the most thickly populated, you can say, Uttar Pradesh, 23.46 crore, and the percentage of fully vaccinated persons are 25%. So states like Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, they are the most challenged states. I think Maharashtra, I can tell you that we have been in the first five. It is because of the complete leadership of Honorable Uddhavji Thackeray and the measures taken by Mahavikas Agadi Sarkar. Now, I would like to highlight the points that we have taken. Like right from the time of incept of COVID, there was a complete task force. This task force was completely utilized for the vaccination planning. There was a huge COVID infrastructure, which was later on used for vaccination. The training of staff, then the vaccination centers run by the government and also run in public-private partnership. Most of the MLAs, MPs, the corporators, they took active participation. It was all political parties. It's not only that just one or two political parties, but all in Mumbai, if you see that in all the 227 wards, we erected all the vaccination centers. Then like targeting the particular groups, like 1 day or 2 days only for women, only for pregnant women, differently disabled, tribals, prisoners, LGBT community, teachers, then varying age groups. So 18 to say 35 or 40, 40 to the next. So then sometimes only first dose, sometimes only second day dose. So all this, we try to reach the maximum people. Okay, then sometimes even those who are at home, okay, the elderly, those who are complete, they cannot move, they cannot be taken to their vaccination centers. So we have started with home vaccination also.
Okay.
And the most important thing that my friend from Karnataka, what he said, is that the deterrent which was used, like going to the malls, restaurants, or even to the theaters. So those who are completely vaccinated, only they can enter, even the trains, buses. So I think now in certain then there was a little laxity, which I must point out here. Then even not giving petrol, not giving certain facilities unless and until you are completely fully vaccinated. So I think these are the major highlights what Maharashtra did. And I think that we have been good enough in that. And of course, now with the onset of Omicron also.
Right.
So this is speeding up.
Okay. Dr. Bagai, you heard both the sides here, you know, the states which are in a way trying to suggest that they are taking innovative and required measures to ensure more and more people get vaccinated. But then why even now in the month of December, only over 50% of our adult population is fully vaccinated? Are we still seeing vaccine hesitancy? Is that the reason why people are not coming forward? Because if governments are taking steps that are required, then why aren't people coming out?
Good evening, Hina. Good evening, everyone. So just let me put some statistics which are interesting and very important to understand put the parameters, and then I'll last 30, 40, 60 seconds, I'll tell you what can actually be done. We have finished 132, which is about 85% of the eligible population has received a single dose, and almost 55% has received the double dose. That decreases the risk of severe infection and death by 93 and 98.9% respectively. Now, I'll tell you why these figures and statistics are extremely important. During the Delta surge, we know that the vaccines reduced the risk of infection ninefold. It decreases the death by 25-fold. And now, with the upsurge of the Omicron, the CDC data is showing sixfold decrease with the double vaccination with regards to infection, and 14 times decrease risk in terms of death. We know that Omicron has actually engulfed most parts of Western Europe, Africa, and is there in almost 28 different countries, and it's showing a great immune escape and vaccine escape. We are now reaching actually a stage in which we have to start thinking of the triple vaccination, which is so-called the booster dose. Now, we have to go forward to make all first shots into double vaccinated and now get a strategy right for the triple vaccination. What is critically important is that even with this state now, we have significantly blunted the community spread and transmission by 25 to 40% by reaching 132. 132 is not a small task. I think all states and the union government have worked fantastically together. It's not an easy task to go from remotest of places to immunize and in a safe and a protocol-driven manner. What can be done now? There is distinct vaccine hesitancy in all stratas of society. What has to be done? It's a community effort. We need to now involve the Indian Medical Association and local medical bodies. This is my strong request and urge. 75% of Indian healthcare is private driven. We know that out of 12 to 13 lakh Indian doctors, more than 8.5 lakhs are in private practice. They have established patient base. We don't have to reinvent the wheels. They have clinics, they have patient following. Involve them in the patient drive. You will double, triple, quadruple the rate of vaccination. Point number two, involve every private clinic for immunization. Let's not only keep it towards major hospitals and major government hospitals or private hospitals. Hina, the reason why I'm saying this is out of about 65 or 70,000 centers, if you see the COVID app, only 2,000 are private. 63,000, 62,000 are government. Liberalize the drive. You will drive home the vaccinations at the last mile coverage much quicker. We have to keep in mind three important points. Winter in most parts of northern India are going to increase the risk of transmission. The pollution increases the risk of transmission. What we really, really not need to do is we don't have to reinvent the wheel, but we need to reinvent a public awareness message. Involve the local community, involve the RWAs, involve the local doctors. Where do the patients go? They come to us. They come to us as medical professionals. And most importantly is involve the local religious leaders. They also have a huge patient base. If there is any, to be eliminated any doubt of whether there is any unnecessary sera in it, which is all fictitious, or it causes any side effects, I think all this needs to be eliminated. We need to work together. No part of India can be safe till every state is safe. This is a domino effect, and we have seen this in various other countries worldwide. All of us have to focus to push. If there is any state which is lagging behind, I think all the other parts of the country need to rally behind that state to push it up. I think it's a unity which we need. We need a unity of purpose. We need a lot of collective thought. This is not a time to criticize anyone why this is down or that is up. I think we all need to put our heads together. If a particular state reaches out to the center that this is lacking, pull out doctors, pull out medical forces from any part of the country to support them. This is the time we need to bat as one India.
Absolutely. And you know, here, Dr. Bagai, you're right. This is not the time to really criticize anyone. We all need to fight this battle together. But then there are lessons that can be learned from the states which are doing well. And that needs to be appreciated as well. The measures that some states are taking. And we also now want, you know, to address the issue of vaccine hesitancy, like you mentioned. mentioned. Now, you know, Dr. Kande, now, recently, the Serum Institute of India has said that there's no new government order, Covishield output to be cut by about 50%. Till about a few months ago, the states were saying we don't have enough vaccine stocks. Now, time has come where probably there's too much of stock available, but maybe people aren't coming forward. What is the situation in Maharashtra?
Well, in Maharashtra, the situation is the vaccine wastage was the lowest. I am not aware of the other states, but I can tell you about Maharashtra that this has been less. So we have utilized how much ever we got. But the thing is, as Dr. Bagai said, that there is this hesitancy. So this has suddenly set in because there was a sharp decrease in the COVID cases. Recovery rate in Maharashtra was very good. And this, you know, laxity, not going to the centers, because initially there was a lot of rush. Then, of course, it was scattered and then people could get vaccinated. But the thing is that this there is a lack of motivation. And that was because of the drop in COVID cases. So it was, you know, a complacency effect that, okay, now everybody around me is vaccinated. So it's okay that if I don't. And there is some hidden fear about being vaccinated. I have TB, I have diabetes, I have blood pressure, and something may happen. So then there were a very, very few deaths, even after double vaccination. So these all added together has somewhere, you know, deterred the people. Okay, you know, this complacency set in that it's okay if I'm not vaccinated. So I think this, as Dr. Bagai said, that we have to involve everybody, like the clinicians, like the religious leaders. I can, in certain communities, the tribals also were scared of getting vaccinated because even normally they don't like allopathic medicines. So in Maharashtra, we took special efforts to vaccinate the tribals with the help of the local public representatives, whether it was the MLAs, MPs. But I think then now with the set of Omicron, I think we have to, you know, involve all the agencies involved in vaccinating the people.
Okay. Dr. Sameer, now I want to ask you, like Karnataka is doing pretty well. Madhya Pradesh is another state which is doing pretty well. Both BJP ruled states. But on the other hand, states like big states, in fact, like Uttar Pradesh, have got just 25% of their adult population fully vaccinated right now. You look at Bihar, 30% only fully vaccinated the adult population there. What is it that you think these big states can learn from a state like yours? Don't you think BJP also now needs to focus on the states a lot more where, you know, probably the vaccination rate isn't too high?
First thing, before I come to this point, I have a couple of other observations on Dr. Bagai's comments. One thing I would want to add here is it's not just a matter of increasing the number of clinics or the number of smaller hospitals for being opened up for vaccination. I don't see that as a bottleneck at all. I mean, we've been able to sort of do 2.5 crore jabs a day, all with 95-98% of them being the government centers. There's no reason why we should believe that you need to open up more centers. What is required, however, I agree with him, is the kind of an education that should go in terms of making sure that the people understand the need for a proper vaccination. And yes, if you look at hesitancy, there is a legacy to it. I mean, it might sound a bit getting into the political part of it, but one needs to understand its entirety. We saw from the month of March and April, when the government of India wanted to start to do it, then the states wanted to do it on their own, then we saw the kind of chaos that the country got in, and once again it went back to the center. But the center, in all its mature leadership under Prime Minister Modi, ensured that they worked closely with all the states across political parties in ensuring that the country gets their vaccination drive in the quickest, most efficient way possible. And that's the reason we are saying, even in a state like Uttar Pradesh or Madhya Pradesh for that matter, there is a good amount of push in terms of getting the vaccination done. The hesitancy part, once again, it unfortunately, extremely unfortunately, got into a political, political push, which was completely avoidable. People called it a BJP vaccine. People called it a Modi vaccine. People said, and when I say people, I'm talking to political leadership, people who are fairly influential, leaders who are fairly influential in their regions. Right?
So are you trying to say that's still having an impact upon people in the states that I mentioned, like UP and Bihar?
Yes. There is, when I say there is a legacy to it, therefore the fact that when you're trying to sort of push, for example, you clearly give a statistic that said earlier there was a huge shortage of vaccines, and today we have 20 crore plus of vaccines with the states and such, right? So as far as the supply is concerned, there are absolutely no issues. So much so that the vaccine manufacturers need to sort of really stagger it and say we'll produce on demand because we have the capability, and as and when there is a demand, we can do it. So then the issue once becomes either of a complacency, in which case the state governments really need to crack the whip, be it in terms of certain privileges or holding back certain privileges, like a mall entry or hotel entry, so on and so forth. And at the same point in time, educate them, saying that this is a medical requirement which is probably brought out by the scientists and the healthcare professionals of the country. It has got nothing to do with one political party. It's a pride of our country. That is the kind of a messaging that each one of us need to take it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a separate thing that it's Prime Minister Modi who's driving it, but it's a pride of our country that the scientists have come up with, right? This is the first part. Second part, asking and coming to what is it, what is it the big states can take it? That way, if you were to look at it, for instance, Madhya Pradesh, they came up with a solid work in terms of maximum dosages per day, right? So they have been able to do it in the predominantly agrarian and rural state like MP. So what is doable in a Madhya Pradesh can be equally doable in a say, in a state like Bihar or Uttar Pradesh. And to give due credit to the UP and the Bihar leadership, they have been doing fairly well, notwithstanding some of the floods and some of the rains that you got during the rainy and the monsoon season that pushed them back by a couple of weeks or probably a month in terms of driving it versus southern states like Karnataka, which were fairly guarded from these kinds of natural calamities, right?
Okay.
So what I think is states are cognizant of it across whichever leadership you would want to sort of take.
Okay.
They are cognizant. They need to be a bit more consistent in terms of driving the people onto it. For instance, if you look at Karnataka.
So we need to be more aggressive with our vaccine awareness drive. That's what you're trying to probably suggest. Dr. Manisha Kayande wanted to respond. Then I'll go across to Dr. Bagai.
Awareness definitely is one.
Yes.
Second, it's also responsibility of the state governments concerned, you know,
yes,
ensuring that the machinery is properly leveraged,
okay,
so that it's a seamless and a convenient way of vaccinating the people.
Got right? it, sir. Dr. Kayande, then Dr. Bagai. Yes.
Well, I would like to point out here that Karnataka's population of 6.4 and MP population of 8.31. So just see the figures, the population compared to the percentage of people who are completely vaccinated. And my friend from Karnataka, as he rightly pointed out and pinpointed rather, that Modi vaccine. I mean, this has absolutely not gone well with people, because we have had a lot of vaccination drives in our country in the past 75 years. We had vaccination for polio and many other diseases, whooping cough, diphtheria, and so many others, MMR. So I think that having somebody's photo, maybe the Prime Minister of the country, I mean, this was absolutely not necessary. It is causing hurdles for all the international travelers. This could have been avoided. Of course, I listen to you, I've heard to you, but this has come from many people. And I think somewhere heart within yourselves, you have to, you know, understand people's problem. At the immigration, when there was a photo of somebody else and not the person who is vaccinated. See, you have to understand, right now you may be, you know, laughing at it, but this is a fact.
Okay.
And many people have come out with this. So I think, you know, see, when there have been so many vaccination drives, which Prime Minister's photo was ever there on the certificate?
Okay, quick response, Dr. Sameer, then I have to go across to Dr. Bagai as well. Very quickly, yes, because you raised your hand. Yes.
And it's confusing two things. One is the hesitation and the intentional political cheap stake in terms of saying, this is a Modi vaccine, therefore I'll not take.
We didn't say, you pointed out, doctor. You pointed out. I didn't say Modi vaccine. It was you who pointed out.
If I have to sort of say, it is Akhilesh Yadav and company. People like Akhilesh Yadav, former CMs of states, speaking that I will not take vaccine because it's a BJP vaccine. This is a Modi vaccine. Nowhere has the government of India claimed that this is a Modi vaccine. I mean, there is a picture.
Why was the photo required? Why was the photo required? Can you give me a simple logical answer?
Let him complete his point. Yes, let him complete his point.
The hesitation is not once you receive a certificate and say, hey, my photo is not there. That's not the point. The point is, The problem when people like former CMs of Uttar Pradesh say this is a BJP vaccine, a Modi vaccine, okay. Therefore it's not safe. Therefore, cutting it out.
Okay. Now, allow me to go across to Dr. Bagai as well, who's been patiently listening to both of you.
Allow me 30
more. Okay, very quickly, 10 seconds, please.
It's extremely naive for anyone to believe that the immigration officer sitting there will mistake Hina's face with Prime Minister.
This has happened.
Okay.
This has happened, Dr. Kalyan.
Okay. I haven't traveled abroad, so I really can't say anything about it. I'll have to believe what Dr. Kayande is saying. But let me now go across to Dr. Bagai. Dr. Bagai, we've heard a lot, you know, in the last many, many months, some political parties coming out and saying, ye toh BJP ki vaccine hai, hum kyun lagwai? On the other hand, I also remember a phase, and I remember discussing it with you as well, that, you know, people wanted Prime Minister Modi to get the first dose so that people of this country also get the confidence to start getting vaccine doses administered. Isn't it?
Yeah, so there's a famous saying, what's in a name? I would say, what's in a photograph? I think we have to go well beyond that. This would be very naive of us to be wondering about whose photograph. If he's the Prime Minister of India and if his photograph is there on the certificate, I value that. I'm absolutely okay with it. But there is a lot of community level, lower level myths which have been created. So I think our campaign should include the following, Hina. It should include statistics of unvaccinated versus double vaccinated in terms of risk of mortality, risk of infection, severe disease, and significant complications. Point number two, our public awareness now should focus on pure statistics. It should be so startling that people should wake up from their slumber and go to the vaccination center and get their vaccines done. Point number two, it should be highlighting that there is no risk of pericarditis, myocarditis, blood clots, thromboembolism, anaphylaxis. These are not mRNA vaccines. These vaccines in India, both the vaccines in Indian diaspora, are extremely safe. We should highlight that the risk of breakthrough infection is extremely low. The ease of giving the vaccine is protocol-driven. It's scientifically driven. Involve the local communities. Again, I'm saying involve the local communities. Involve the local medical base. You have a ready base of lakhs of doctors who are more than willing to come and help. This is a need of the hour for India. I think all the doctors in every state should be involved. With regards opening more centers, I'm not at all suggesting to opening more centers, but use the centers which are already pre-existing. You will only increase the penetration that much quicker. For a hepatitis B or an influenza or for a hepatitis A or a chickenpox vaccine, we don't go to designated centers. It should be as easy as walk in, get it done, have it monitored, have it registered. Data is very important. So get the data done and walk out. We need now to push at more than 1 crore per day towards end of this year. We have to reach a figure of 170 to 180 crore injections to reach significant level of community acquired immunity. That is our aim. There is no divide. And I would still say there is no divide. Every political figure, which is a public figure, should aid in the vaccination drive, should not be an hindrance. It's extremely important. Those comments from certain political parties in UP have really hurt us. Even till date, we want to highlight that there is no animal protein, there is no significant risk. It is extremely safe. It can be used even in pregnancy. We are now reaching a stage in which we will be looking at a strategy to immunize children, the third vaccine strategy and so on. So now we need to move on. Like I said, what's in a name, what's in a photograph? I think we should have respect for the Prime Minister. If he's the Prime Minister, that's what it is.
Okay, Dr. Kayande, closing comments.
Yes, closing comment is, I do appreciate the comments of both. But if the photo is going to add as a deterrent, I mean, if I would have been the Prime Minister, I would have said, okay, if my photo is a problem, it's a deterrent to vaccination or people don't want it, please remove my photo. That is my last comment.
Dr. Sameer, I'll give you time to quickly respond now to Dr. Kayande.
It's as is rightly said, if you think that your photo is going to be a deterrent, Dr. Kayande, you're free not to have that. Definitely, yes.
I'm talking of the Prime Minister's photo, not mine. I'm talking, if I were the Prime Minister, I would have said, okay, please remove my photo if people don't want to get vaccinated because it's a Prime Minister's photo.
He's also seeing you as the Prime Minister. So you see glass half full here, what Dr. Sameer is talking about. Dr. Sameer, last comment, yes. Yes.
The last comment is one thing very clear. It's as Dr. Bagai said, definitely a matter of pride for a country like India to have been in the midst of this unprecedented pandemic, nevertheless, taken a very, very strong leadership step, producing a vaccine, two vaccines in India, getting the scientific community ensure that we are completely Atmanirbhar in the vaccination right. production and delivering, right? So that being the case, if the majority of the people stand proud of their country and the country's prime minister, we should applaud it, welcome it, and with a renewed vigor, with a redoubled vigor, go out and ensure that the hesitancy caused by unwanted politics is
right.
removed. Make sure that the entire country gets vaccinated.
All Thank right. You. I'm completely out of time now, but I appreciate all of you for this very, very civil debate. Thank you very much for joining us. Heading into a short break, more updates on the other side. Stay with us.